Welcome! Today we're going to look at how to print a red and black label from your QL810W. This video will cover multiple models and operating systems. Even though your machine may not match the model on the screen, the overall process will be the same. Before beginning, verify that you have installed the printer driver as well as the PTouch Editor application. If you are missing any of the software, download it from brother-usa.com/support. You will also need to make sure you're using a two-color compatible label. To verify the two-color compatibility of a roll, check the label backing or the side of the spool.
So we'll go in and we'll just go to File and click New. And then we're going to click on New Layout to get a blank layout for the label. Then we have our new layout here. The first thing we're going to do, since we want a red and black label, is to come over here and click Switch to Print Color Media. We will click that, and it'll tell us that it's setting it for two color. And then we will have the color wheel over here to be able to select for our different text, outlines, and fill colors. So the first part we'll do of this label is to create the black box. We'll take that and we will draw the box here. Then we will click on the outline to change it to black. And then we want to fill this in, so we will right click with our mouse and click on Properties. And then in the fill type, we're going to click Pattern. And then on the form side, we will select the solid color here. And that will fill it in black. The next part that we're going to do is make for where the danger word is going to appear. We'll make an ellipse here. And then we will right click on it again. Get to Properties. We will click on the pattern and we will click on the solid color again, so that gets filled in. Then at this point, we will change the fill color, which is this menu here, to red. And then the outline has a white outline around it, so we will click on white. We will click again on properties just to make that a little bit heavier weight, 1.5, and then click OK. And then we will move this up into the black area here. And now we have the start of our part. The next part, we'll do the word danger. So here we'll click on the text, and then we'll type the word danger in. And then we will highlight this, and we will change it to white. So we click on the set color and we'll change that to white, and then we'll take this and we'll move it into the red area here. We'll make it a little bit smaller so that it fits. You can also use the arrow keys to then move the danger into the center. And there we have that. Then we will click on the text again to add the do not enter part. Type in do not. New line, enter. Now we'll basically move this over here. Like that. And then we will add again to make the circle. Here, we'll come over here and change the outline to red. And then we are going to right click again to get the properties to make the weight a little bit bigger. So we'll select the weight, make that 3 points. And then now we have our circle. And then we'll come up here to the line tool. Pick that and we will draw a line across. Make the do not enter symbol. Again, we'll right click, click on the arrow for selecting, on properties, and we'll set that to the same weight of 3 points. And then we have that. So the next thing, the last thing we got to do is add the little person to this. We'll click on insert. So in PTouch Editor, we have the ability for symbols and clip art. We'll click on symbol, and we see under the PTouch symbols, we have the little person here. We'll click on that, insert them in, make them a little bigger. We'll go and change the fill color to black, and we'll make them a little bit smaller to fit into the circle. Here, and we click on order, we send to the back, and then the red line will come in front of him as well. So then lastly, we just have to create a frame. Around the person, so we'll go to insert frame, and we can pick the round corner frame. And that will draw that around there. We'll just change that to black. And then we have a similar close representation of the label that we made here. And then lastly, all you have to do is then click the print button, and it will send this to the printer and print out our newly created label.
For more tutorials, FAQs, and videos, visit us at www.brother-usa.com. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe. Thank you for choosing Brother.